Gotti, hard body, Gotti's world, we some mob bosses. Tune in, don't just come across. We do it all, y'all just for the talk. Might lose your mind when you hear these topics, no cap, think about it. Who you know going this hard, all real, always think about it. Best interview, so is this? We don't do oldest, that entrepreneurship. Come and link, join the viewership. Education, relationships, businesses, view the clips. This the Midwest takeover, going over time to invent, I'm focused. Bringing guests in from all over, whole lot of game, we don't need a closer. Gotti, hard body, Gotti's world, we some mob bosses. Turn them L's to lessons, we don't do the losses. Dedication daily, ain't no other options. Booking up these lots on every show, we plotting. Pull up a chair, make sure you watching. Subscribe, get them notifications popping. Pull up all the champagne, we gon' get it poppin'.
Yo, what's going on, y'all? This is your boy Gotti on the Gotti's World Show. Today is a very special day, man. I'm gonna tell you this, man, how this brother came across me, man. And when I did my homework, it seemed like shit, he been in it, but I think somebody helped me pull him out the woodwork. You know what I mean? And I'm surprised he slipped past me. Because I got my eye on a lot of shit, but I see why, because he be in and out. And, man, and I was going through, doing my homework, doing my history on him, and we just talked about it. He knows a lot of people. He's been around a lot of motherfuckers, a lot of people. And I'm telling y'all, when y'all see, when I introduce this person here, whew. He got a story, and we finna figure it out, man. So, hey, y'all give it up for my man, Dutch.
What's up?
What's the word, gang?
What up, dude? What up?
How you feel?
I'm great.
Yes, sir, man. Like I was saying, bro, you slipped past me. And when the big homie, he reached out and said, man, my man, he need to get on there.
Right.
And I'm just like, all right, well, shit, well, you know it's coming through you. Whatever.
Right.
Whatever. So I started doing my homework and I'm like, damn, this thing been around for a long fucking time.
Yes, sir.
And then earlier when we politic, you was telling me, and as I started scrolling and doing my thing, I'm like, damn, he has been around for a long ass time.
Yes, sir.
And bro, I gotta get your story, G. So how I don't know if you've seen the show, but how I start this thing off, man, is for you. In the morning, how do you center yourself in the morning before you go out and handle your business in this crazy world?
Well, I actually have a job, you know what I'm saying? So
okay.
When I go to work, I mean, I just got to wake up and, you know, you just got to do it sometimes, you know what I'm saying? Roll one up and then you just go on. You know, you do what you got to do, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I've been stuck in that routine for a minute now, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Definitely.
So bro, let's go from the past and then we're gonna go to the present and then, you know, the future.
Right.
Where you grew up at, bro?
A little bit of everywhere, you know what I'm saying? I started on 92nd in Halsted.
Okay.
Know what I'm saying? And then I ended up moving to Dalton.
She okay.
Got real, had to move to Dalton, you know what I'm saying? Stayed in Dalton through grade school and high school, you know, junior high school.
Yes, sir.
And then from there, I moved to 87th. From there, I moved to 75th. From there, I moved downtown. From there, I moved to the north side. From there, I moved back to Dalton.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Okay. So I'm a little everywhere.
Okay. So is it safe to say that you don't like to be and you don't like to be complacent, you don't like to be too well, I mean, be somewhere too long?
No,
or is
I'm
it
cool.
Just because of?
I'm comfortable everywhere. I mean, doing the rapping got me in areas I never thought I'd be in, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I'm comfortable everywhere.
Okay.
You know
okay.
What I mean?
As far as with growing up though, tell me a little bit about how it looked in your household as a child. What did that look like through your eyes?
I figured it was pretty much every black man, probably mostly black man, went through, you know what I mean? Pops was there at an early age to a certain extent, and then he rolled out kind of early, you know, and then it was just me, moms, and little sister pretty much when I got of age, you know what I'm saying? So, and then that's all it's really been, you know what I mean?
Do you, it is a little, like, to be honest, it is how a lot of we grew up.
Right.
You know, a lot of the pops wasn't even, you know, he was absent from the home. Did you
see? But my pops had rolled out, but after a while, he was still in the picture. He just wasn't back in the house.
Okay, you know okay, 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 good.
So, like, yeah, he still was in the picture. So, I mean, you know.
See, with my father, he moved. They had their situation.
Right.
He dipped out, and he was gone for a while. We just now rekindling our relationship. Okay. Maybe probably, like, 2 years ago, we just now started getting,
right,
you know what I'm saying, jammed tight. But even with your father not being in the household presently, and him being still in the picture, though,
right?
What type of morals did he install into you, even though he wasn't physically in the household? Because sometimes that can play a difference when somebody's facts. There every day, and he's, you know what I'm saying, he's there every day, but
facts,
not at night, you know what I mean?
Right. Well, my father definitely installed the fact of, like, you know, being a man, you know what I mean? Like, taking care of the household first, you know what I'm saying? I definitely got... You know, you got your other vices or habits or whatever you like to do, you know what I'm saying? But I definitely know how to take care of the crib first, you know what I'm saying? It's always going to be a crib, somewhere to stay, you know what I mean? Bills going to always be paid, you know what I mean? That's foundation is always going to be laid, you know what I'm saying? And he definitely showed me how to do that, you know what I mean, number one. I mean, moms did too as well, you know what I'm saying, though?
Yeah. Was that at an early age and, you know, just taking care of the crib and things like that, did you have... that kind of like that man responsibility early?
In a way, yeah. Yeah. I mean, they definitely made me start bringing money in once high school hit. Okay. And start, you know what I mean? I definitely was taking garbage out, you know, stuff like that. But but you had to do other things to do what you wanted to do. You know what I'm saying? So that's when other things came into play, because it's like, I still got to be me. You know what I'm saying? I still got to look the way I'm trying to look.
Indeed.
You know what I mean?
Indeed. Now, far as with the music, what did that play in? How did you even get into that? And why did you even choose music? Or did it was just like a, shit, let me go ahead and see what's happening?
Music, I was a major Pac fan.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So me and my man, shout out to Terrence T. Black, you know what I'm saying?
Shout out.
We came up together. We was Pac fans, you know, and it was just, you know, he just made me want to rap. Pac made me want to rap. Terrence was rapping at the time, and he made me want to rap, you know what I'm saying? And then I just took it from there, you know what I'm saying? And then, I mean, this was a time when everybody was footworking, you know what I mean?
Okay, okay.
Like, so no one...
So it wasn't even really the thing.
Yeah, it wasn't the thing then. This was everybody was footworking. Pac just died. You know, I was on the rap thing, you know what I'm saying? And,
It was foreign to everybody for a minute.
It was foreign. But it didn't want nobody teaching me how to footwork, so I had to figure out something.
You know? Did you even want to go? Did you even want to?
I did.
You want to do it? I still can't do that shit.
I still can't do it either. I can't do it either. I still know the best ones in the city, but I can't footwork, though. Straight up.
So what is that? Getting into it and actually putting your foot in it and starting it. Like, give me that process, or if you remember that story, what was that?
That was hard. That was hard because I was dealing with people that was also just starting as far as engineers or studio people, and they sitting there trying to tell you how you supposed to sound. And, you know, you being fresh in the game, you don't know if you should be listening to them or you should be, you know, doing what you're supposed to do anyway. You know what I mean? So I had people out there that I was recording with that was like, no, this is the way we supposed to sound. So it was like, I had to say, I don't want to sound like that, and I'm not drawing off y'all no more. So I stopped drawing off them, you know what I mean, went my own direction. And from there, I just was doing, I ran up running to some other guys, and we was doing us all through high school, you know what I mean? And then I ended up going downtown, and I took it a little more serious. And from downtown, I end up messing with a chick that was messing with Trackster.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? Gotcha. And so, like, I had to figure out how to maneuver into that circle. You
indeed.
Know what I'm saying?
Shit, the way you maneuvering, what was that? Oh, let me go back. Being an artist, being a rapper, was it a passion or you feel like it was your purpose?
I felt like it was a passion until I got downtown. When I got downtown, stuff started happening that was freakish. Like, it was like cards start lining up too much for me, and I started seeing it like, maybe I'm really supposed to be doing this, because okay, I'm starting to run into people that, you know, that I grew up listening to, you know.
That's them people.
Yeah, that's them people. So I'm like, let me put more into it. You know what I'm saying? And then I put more into it, and I dedicated myself to it. You know what I'm saying? And then I got up with Traxxer, and then I went from a friend to being an artist.
So when you start taking it serious and you start really getting yourself into them circles and networking and knowing some of these people and seeing some of these people politicking, what is some of the differences that you see now with how you did it and how
they doing it now?
Go ahead, come on. Don't hold it up.
Okay, when I did it, right, Traxxer assigned me as an intern. I was in school for learning how to engineer, because okay, I figured if I was going to be in school, it had to be music related. Other than that, I'm not interested in nothing in school. You know what I mean? I'd have been left. You know what I'm saying? So right, it has to be music related. So when he found that out, he was looking for interns because his schedule was getting so busy that he needed people to run the studio while he was gone. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So boom, you know, I'm one of those people. You know what I mean? So while I'm in there, it's like I got a secret agenda. I'm really a rapper. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to play this role until I can not play this role. You know what I'm saying? So I'm playing this role. And back then, it was about talent. You know what I mean? It was just about talent. Like, you couldn't rap. You couldn't get in it if you wasn't really talented. No type of level. You know what I'm saying? So it was hard because I ain't going to lie. Back then, I wasn't ready. I mean, he knew I wasn't ready. But being around them in that world for years, I was signed to him for 9 years. Being around him in that world for years, and the people that came around, the Johnny P's, you know, kicking it with Johnny P, kicking it with Twist, kicking it with Direct from Triple Darkness, kicking it with a Psychodrama, you know.
He's dropping a lot of names, big dog.
Snipers, you know what I mean? He's
dropping a lot of names, big dog.
It was game, like it was just game. And watching them, I'm talking about late nights, 47, 45th in Michigan. I'm talking about 3 a.m, I'm watching them, you know what I mean? Studios, rehearsals, you know what I mean? You just learn, you know what I mean? And I developed how to get the way I am, you know what I'm saying? And then I got cold. But now you don't have to be cold. You know what I mean? All you have to have is a gimmick or know how to do. You do something, you could luck up and do something. Now you could do something. You could luck up and do something and make a song and get a deal and not know how to do it again.
A lot of motherfuckers is not putting in work, bro. Facts. They not putting in their 10,000 hours.
Facts.
It's a lot of social media hype. It's a lot of social media cap.
Facts.
And that's why it will continue to stay microwave.
If it don't die first.
You think it'll die? But you know what? I know some spitters, bro. I didn't have some spitters on here, and they really dedicated. They really about the shit.
Right.
But it's so crazy. Like, they like little jewels that you just find, but they don't get that.
That's the problem. Cause I'm one of them. I'm not finna put on a wig. I'm not finna, you know what I mean? I'm not finna do nothing extra for you to say, let me listen to his music. You feel me? Cause I know on paper I can eat anybody or most people that's doing it. You know what I'm saying? But it's a political game. You know what I'm saying?
But you was really even just listening to the music going back and then coming a little forward, I would even say that you was the real street rap, though.
Yeah.
You was the real street rap, bro. Like, you was in that era.
Right.
Hold on.
Shout out to E-Dub the Gangster, because you finna play it right.
Hold on. Hold on.
Yo, gang ain't shit compared to my gang.
Yeah.
Wherever the fuck I'm at, that's where I bang. Chi-town boy,
bang.
Speak Chi-slang. And I ain't hard to find, you know where I hang.
Yeah.
Your gang ain't shit compared to my gang.
Hey.
Your gang ain't shit compared to my gang.
Yeah.
Your gang ain't shit compared to my gang.
Squad, no new niggas, these marks scar. My era vibe, Gucci, Cole Black, Shorty G, nigga, Mark Clark. I don't get these dudes, these niggas fools. I'm a 90s gangster, different rules. They savage now, we called it goons. I'm both of those, don't get shit confused. No question about it, nigga, I'm a G. Cashed out mini blocks, check my receipt. Niggas knew me out west, even by the greens. Robert Taylor's, nigga, out of B's. I done seen so much through your GD glasses. GD's clashing, the BD's blasting. Lame niggas turned to assassins, and the whole time, CPD laughing. Like psychodrama, been and done some shit. In Chicago, minute fuck one, we run this bitch. I'm speaking out cause I'm from this bitch. If they silence me, you better slump some shit. Cook County, nigga, I was raised and born.
Son, where'd you find this?
So much drugs cause I hate the norm, but it made me a killer like Jason Bourne. It's on gang.
Your gang ain't shit compared to my gang.
Yeah.
Wherever the fuck I'm at, that's where I bang. Chi-town boy, speak Chi-town.
Shout out E-Dub, the gangster.
Come on now. Come on now, bro. That's it's different.
Different. It's different.
That's yes, different. Sir. Compared yes, to what we hear now, bro, that is the yeah. staple.
Yeah.
To me.
Yeah.
That's Bo Deal era. That's kind of who else? G Count.
Yes, sir.
G Count them.
Yeah,
LEP.
Shout out G Count.
Come on, all them. That's yes, that's that Bump J. That's
yes, sir.
That's all around that era.
Mm-hmm.
That's the staple, bro.
Mm-hmm.
You miss that?
I miss that, bro. I miss it. I miss that. Matter of fact, that's why we got that show tomorrow. You know what I mean? Anytime T or Triple Darkness or Snipers and Psychodrama performing, we definitely with them. You know, Drama War Love. You know what I'm saying? We got the show tomorrow, Joliet. We doing with them, so. Come out if you can at the Forge.
At the Forge. At the Forge in Joliet, man. Y'all make sure y'all pull up on that. What's the times?
Shit, the doors open at 7.
Okay.
You know, definitely pull
up. All right. Man, why did you take your little hiatus, though? You got to be honest with me because it's like, I understand it. And I understand life happens. And then when you do something so much, you just like, man, let me take a break. But then you just like, man, or you just lose the feeling sometimes. This is what I hear sometimes. And then just me going through it, I just be like, man, I need a break, bro.
I put in a lot of work, bro.
I know.
You know what I'm saying? And the tracks of the era ended in California. You know what I mean? We was in Cali. We was living in Cali at the time.
Okay.
You know, negotiating with Def Jam. You know what I'm saying? It's 9 years in, you know what I'm saying? And that didn't work out, you know what I'm saying? So came home, you know what I mean? End up, you know, getting up with B-Lo, you know, from Do or Die for about a year, you mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? And then I started doing my own thing for about another 3-4 years, you know what I'm saying? And that was the last joint I dropped that album right there. I mean, it's more like, I realized it wasn't gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't gonna happen. You know what I mean? So at this point, I'm doing it because I like doing it. I ain't doing it no more to get a deal. You know what I mean? If like, you know, I'm the one, you put a goal here, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna drive to get it. You know what I'm saying? But once you realize it wasn't gonna happen, then it was like, I'm doing this for fun. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, at the end of the day, and then, you know, I'm getting older, bro. You know what I'm saying? I might look a little young, but, you know, I'm a little older. You feel me? I'm 38. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, ain't nobody 38 still going to the court no more. You mean, how many people still going to the rec shooting? You know what I mean? I was doing it at 12.
It's for fun.
You feel me? You know what I mean? This is fun. You feel me? And I know I'm cold with it. You feel me? So every now and then I'll sit back and then I'll watch the streets, just the rap game just get garbage. And then I'll be like... Let me just jump in real quick and just to throw this out here just for real rap listeners. You know what I mean?
But being the artist that you are and being how cold you are, like, you don't when I really say you don't miss the games, where it's like, they ain't doing it right. They ain't doing this shit right.
Right.
Let me go ahead and, or either cuff a shorty to where you might see he trying or something like that, and you just cuff him and then put him in a different direction and you play the background.
That's what I would like to do, you know what I'm saying? Like,
so what the hell we doing?
You know what it is, bro? It's a lot of energy. Like, I mean, shout out to my man Mickey Halston. Mickey Halston was definitely on the label. With Tracks the Ink with us, you know what I mean? And he definitely took that route, and you see where it got him. You feel me? With G Herbo, you feel me? So,
yeah.
You know what I mean? That's definitely the move to make, you know what I'm saying? I just, man, it's just, I know it's like, he had more connections than I do. I don't, like it'll be a lot of energy, like a lot of bread, you feel me? And I just had a shorty, my first shorty, like a year ago, you know what I'm saying? So it was like, thank you, you know? So it was like, rap was my shorty, you know what I mean? It's easy to put 5,000 on a video because it's my shorty. But now that I got a real shorty, why would I put 5,000 on that shorty when I could put 5,000 on a real shorty? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And then that's when I start doing it. And then that's what this is. I realized that no matter how much talent you got, this is a money game. You feel me? I could barely speak English. I could just rap ABCs. But if I got 10,000 on this song, it's gonna get played 29,000 times and everybody gonna love it.
Places, yes sir.
But if I got a real record and I ain't got $5 on it, no one will hear it. You feel me? Politics.
It's definitely politics. And why, even with it being politics, bro, do you think that hinders a lot of people?
No, I think it hinders the game.
The game. That's what I meant to say. I'm sorry. The game.
It hinders the game.
In what ways do you think? Because I got my own specific ways that it does, but what about yours?
It hinders the game because it allows people that can't do it with money to do it.
But don't you think we still have gatekeepers?
We do.
We still have gatekeepers in this city.
Mm-hmm.
We still have them. And you don't think that they made it about the bread. In my head, they made it about the bread. If a shorty coming in and they ain't got no bands, or it's like, what's in it for me, or this and this, then I can't do nothing for you.
Yeah.
So the shorty from wherever, and he just doing shit, and he seen something on TV, and he got to say, man, I'm working, but I can give you this. Oh, come on, shorty, we can figure it out.
Right.
But the shorty who really hungry, and he really like, he got it. They just like, he just got to figure it out and find his way through the cracks.
Exactly. That's the problem. That's exactly why it's a guy that could beat Michael Jordan that never made it to the NBA. You know what I'm saying? That's exactly why it's a guy that can rap better than Jay-Z that you'll never hear. You feel me? Because he didn't have all that extra shit to get there. You know what I'm saying?
So that's where it comes around to where it's like people like you.
Facts.
And I'm trying, if you notice, I'm trying to pull you in a little way to where, you know what I'm saying, to where you can get your ass back out here.
I mean,
and
no,
really start.
No, actually, I'm actually rotating. You feel me? That's why I reached out to Big Homie and told Big Homie to reach out to you. You feel me?
Yes, sir.
I'm coming back outside. You feel me? I'm trying to get back outside. I got it.
That's all I like to hear.
Me and E Dub. Like, you know what I'm saying? I have a partner I rap with, you know what I'm saying? E Dub the gangster, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, shout out E Dub.
Shout out E Dub. He was with Seawall with me, you know what I'm saying? And we definitely trying to get back out here. It's just like, you know, when you know you cold, and then it's like, I don't know. Like, I gotta see the love, you know what I'm saying? That's the motivation. You know what I mean? We're like, okay, you know what I mean, y'all, I know what I could do, you feel me?
But is it not an easy play for you since you was in it already, and also you know the people? Oh, it's really just calls and
that's what I'm
really relationships.
We about to see. At the same time, like, the game's so different.
It's that definitely.
You gotta call people you never called. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, I got these calls, but now the game's like this, so now I gotta figure out how to get their number. Like that's why I'm
yes,
here.
Sir.
You
yes,
know
sir.
What I'm saying?
Yes,
like, this is something new. You know what I'm saying? Like,
This goes further.
Yeah.
And it ain't no money plays.
Right.
This goes further after this.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Right, right.
Like, you invested in me.
Right.
I return the love back.
All day.
And especially when it's the big homie that's saying, hey, look out for my people.
Right.
You got it.
Right.
Whatever he's, you got it.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's like, man, like, okay, whatever. Whatever you need, promo, whatever you need, whatever you need. Right. Boom, I'm doing this here. I'm doing this. I got this going here. Come slide through. Do what you got to do. Yes, here go some artists.
Yes, sir.
Put them in, whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Whatever, bro. But it's shit like that that I feel like that's how we get our blessings. But like I said, it's some of these gatekeepers and this money play shit. It's just,
it yeah.
blows some of the love and shit out.
A lot of the love.
Because everybody about the money right now, too.
Facts. Facts.
Everybody about it.
That's what it's all about.
When you said you realized it wasn't going to happen, what did that do to your confidence and what did that do to you emotionally?
It killed me. You know what I'm saying? It killed me because it's like I've been doing this so long. You know what I'm saying? And it's like I got so far. You know what I mean? Like to be sitting in Cali with Def Jam, you know what I mean? Just to come home to say, let me spend another 9 years to go back to Cali to talk with Def Jam. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I mean? Like, cause that's Interscope, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. that's the goal.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? To come from the block to there. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, let me get a job. You feel me? And that's what I did. When I came back, I got a job. You feel me? And I've been working ever since. But before that, it was rap life. You know what I mean? How, you know, mm-hmm. I'm eating hot at it.
Running around, getting, doing what you gotta do.
Right.
Stuff like that. Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, but yeah, when I came back, it was like, let me get a job. You know what I mean? Cause you know, it's a young man's game. You know what I mean? I don't have another 9 years. You know what I'm saying?
But is it really a young man's game though? I mean, yes, they have time on their side, but is it really a young man's game? Because, man,
if you eating off of it, it's not. You know what I'm saying? But if you can't be trying to eat.
Gotcha.
And you yeah, 34 yes, plus trying to have a house and a home and a family. You
yes,
know what
sir.
I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes,
I can't
sir.
Be, you know, no, I got to, I'm counting on this to come in for rent. No, I know rent here. You know what I'm saying? I got rent already.
Yes,
you know
sir.
What I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. When you stepped away, did a lot of people step away from you?
No.
Did you lose a lot of people along the way?
No, I didn't lose a lot of people. I mean, I honestly never felt like I got the love I was supposed to get anyway. You know what I mean? All my love came from most people that I didn't know. You know what I mean? Most of my love didn't come from my high school friends or none of that. You know what I mean? Most of my love came from people I just met on this journey. You know what I'm saying? That was like, nah, bro, you got to keep this going. You one of the coldest rappers I've ever heard. You know what I'm saying?
Big fan.
So, and then like the same way with like when I got a song with Mano, you know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Mano.
I don't know if he's operating, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? So Mano, somebody's on Mano's side saw the video on World Star, you know what I'm saying? It reached out to me. I got a lot of people reached out because of that. Joel Santana reached out to me, you know, a few people game. You know what I mean? A lot of people reached out to me through videos they saw on WorldStar. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it was just definitely it was a plus. You know what I'm saying? Like, to try to expand. You know what I'm saying?
Did that momentum that you had, and I know it's going to be like hell putting that hat back on, you know what I mean? With the, what you call it, do you feel like you're going to have a drive when you get back in it, though? Do you really? Because you can't be 1 foot out. Like, because
right.
If it is, do you feel like even getting back into this or trying to get back into this, you think you're going to have the drive still to get back into it? Or it's going to be like a, nope.
I ain't gonna lie, I don't know. I mean, honestly, I think I would have the drive because now it's for fun. You know what I'm saying? You get let down when you're trying to do something, you know what I'm saying? And you see this person that's garbage doing this and you trying to do this or you ain't, you know what I mean, knocking on the right doors or, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, now, I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Now it's fun, you feel me? It's like, that's how it was when it started. Like, that's another reason why it kind of fell off for me, because it became a job. You know what I mean? It wasn't fun no more. You know what I mean? Like, it's fun again because I fell out. You know what I mean? Now I'm not expected to do this. I'm not here to do this. You know what I mean? Now it's like, it's fun again. You feel me? I don't have no expectations.
And that's why, low-key, a lot of these industry people that's in there be doing a lot of weird shit because they so obligated that this is their job, yeah, and they have to do certain things and contracts and all this other stuff like that.
Right.
They ain't doing it for the fun no more, so they do a lot of crazy shit,
right,
to have fun,
mm-hmm,
and then, you know, or cope with their job at that point in time. So I do agree with that, bro. If it ain't fun, bro, like, you know, if you can't find a way to make this shit fun, then...
Right, then it's pointless, you know.
Then it's pointless. It's very pointless.
You know.
How you get so connected? I mean, I understand you did tell me the story, but you still locked in? Because I see you still with, you know, with the Twistas and things like that. It's,
man,
is it like a real, real relationship there?
I don't draw... Me and Traxa, I haven't talked in a while. You know what I'm saying? It's been a while for Traxa, but he's definitely the big homie, you know what I'm saying, for all that he's put me through, you know what I'm saying? And but I haven't talked to him in a while. I end up meeting T, you know, through mutual friends, you know what I'm saying? Because I kick it with everybody. Like, I have a hell of a story. Living downtown, I lived in the same building with White Boy James, you know what I'm saying, and the Legit Ballers. You know
okay.
what I'm saying? So I ended up running into them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just, in the rap world, I just met everybody. You know what I'm saying? So I be with Ty Nitty from the Legit Ballers, Maze. You know, certain people around or bring me around him, direct from Triple Darkness. You know what I'm saying? And then when I get around him, then I form the relationship with him. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's definitely always love when I come around. You know what I mean? We kick it and all that. And I'm actually finna try to do another song, put him on the project.
Okay.
I'm trying to reach out to Ty Money, you know what I'm saying? Trying to work with people I haven't worked with, you know what I'm saying?
Sorry as hell to get to him.
I see. I'm gonna ask the big homie to get to him too.
Yeah. It's hard as hell because I didn't try to get him on here too. It's just hard, man. He moving and shaking, bro.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to reach him. But no, I mean, all the OGs, you know, I got love with, you feel me? Crucial Conflict, you know what I mean? Everybody that made me do or die, shout out to B-Lo especially, you feel me? He didn't help me down.
Shout out.
He held me down when I was lost, you feel me? I didn't know what was going on, you feel me? He held me down, let me get on the label, you know what I mean? Just all the OGs that paved the way, you feel me? Because they the reason why I rap the way I rap now, you know what I mean?
Indeed. Okay, let's go ahead and get into some life shit. We did the music. We still gonna tap into the music too. Let's get into some life shit, man. What you had your child.
Yes, sir.
What did that do to you?
That changed
as a man.
That changed me. As a man, that also made me slow down on the rap because this ain't the same time we was in. You know what I mean? Like, I'm 38, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So like, you know, back then, it was a lot of people getting killed, but it was mostly, you was getting killed for a purpose. You know what I'm saying? I hate to say that, but you know, it was. Now, it's senseless. It's senseless everywhere. You know, E-ways, all type of stuff.
Niggas just doing
Just shoot. You know what I'm
doing
saying?
That.
And so it's like, I don't want him getting of age and now he's seeing me in videos doing what I used to do
with that.
And he's trying to copy it in a new era and don't do it right. You know what I'm saying? And then it'd be, nah, I got to come out my body. You know what I'm saying? So I don't even, you know, so I had to think twice. And that's why another reason why I kind of fell back on the visuals, you know what I'm saying? But I'm just going to put them things down and just shoot some more visuals. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Now I'm still on the man thing. How does the lyrical pen going to sound? Now
I want you to know
from the past shit.
I'm killing the old shit. You feel me? I'm talking about out of it writing. I'm like, damn, this is gonna sound way different. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's seasoned. You know what I mean? That's why I'm trying to. The new project might be called Legendary or something, like something to show my seasoned status. You know what I'm saying? Because the flow is definitely advanced in a certain way. I'm proud of it, you know what I mean? That's why I feel like it has to be a seasoned album to come out just to show the growth for all fans that have been following me since my first project. My first project came out in 2008, you know what I'm saying? So I done had like 6-7 projects since then, you know what I mean? That was the last one, so.
That penmanship.
Yeah, I got a problem. I got a problem. I'll be reading it like, who wrote this? Like
What is the process? What's the process? What's your process?
My process is just get involved in the beat. Like, I mean, I hate to say this, but like, pain used to motivate me writing a lot. Like, I could take pain and write about anything. Like, yeah. Anything go wrong, let it be in the life. You know what I mean? You know, get into it, whatever, girl problems, whatever. You mad, I could go write about anything. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But now, life is good. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's harder to write because I'm used to writing for pain. But I just get high. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to keep it 100. I just get high as hell. You know what I'm saying? And just get in the beat, like to the point where I'm in the beat. Like, I'm not on top of the beat no more. I don't hear the beat. I'm in the beat. You know what I'm saying? In the beat. Once I get in the beat tells me, it tells me what the song's supposed to say.
Who you getting your, some of your beats from?
Nah, that's a question, right? You know, because I'm very picky. Like at a certain, I was groomed on Trackster. You know what I'm saying? So it's hard, you know what I mean? Right. And like, you know everybody, so you don't want to let nobody down, you know what I'm saying? And I didn't mess with everybody. We had some dope producers in the city, you know what I'm saying? Other than Trackster too, you know what I'm saying? But I'm talking about like, so I'm definitely trying to work with Excel again. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if you know Excel, Excellency.
I've heard.
He's definitely super dope. I've been working with Dirty Sock, you know what I'm saying? Dirty Sock is a dope producer, you know what I mean, from the West Side, you know what I mean? He did a lot of Twist and Do or Die projects and songs, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, I'm kind of picky, you know what I mean? I'm messing with some new cats right now, you know what I mean? But right now, I had to go back to Dirty Sock for Old Faithful, you know what I'm saying? Jesse Parks got some good beats. There's some good producers out here, you know what I mean? But I need the beat to tell me, you know what I mean? I just need it to tell me. Like Heron, Rio Mac.
Just spoke to Heron about a week or something. Heron, you know, and he out of here. You gotta.
I haven't spoke to Heron since that album. That was 2 years ago. He did a song on that album, me and Shamika. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, yeah, that was the last time I talked to Heron, but that's my boy. Shout out. I've been drawing off Heron since high school. You know what I mean?
Wait till this nigga see this. Wait till he see this. My guys, I already know, bro. I already know. Yeah. Far as with, like I said, you do have your baby. How are you gonna maneuver even if shit start picking up though? Where you gonna find that balance at?
That's the twist, cause I mean it ain't even, cause that's the second job right there. That's really the first job. I have a real job, and then you gotta come home and then do that job. So then now I'm adding on another job. You know what I'm saying?
Fact.
So it's like, I don't know. It's going to be hard. You know what I mean? That's why I don't rush music. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, I got too much going on. You know what I'm saying? And then you force it, and then they don't sound like you want it to sound. So it's like, I don't care how long it takes me to write a song or what it takes. Like, if I'm feeling it, and sometimes I'll be half verse and then I lose it, then I'm dropping a pen there. You know, if I don't care if I pick it back up next week. Like,
yeah.
Because when I'm done, it's going to be what it's supposed to be.
It's going to be completed.
You know what I'm saying?
What do you think that your peers that was in it with you, how they gonna feel when you step back in?
Which ones? Like I got different sets of peers.
You do.
I got different lives. You know what I mean? I got different lives. But I mean, the high school peers, they didn't really care anyway.
The rap peers, put it like this. Let's put it, the rap peers, the one that was in the game, in them studios with you, some of the people that was on that album, like that, or your past album.
They always down. They definitely down with it. Direct from Triple Darkness has always encouraged me to keep going. You know what I'm saying? Everybody that I've worked with always asked me to just, why was I slowing down anyway? You know what I mean? So I mean, they always wanted me to come back anyway, so. It would be easy for them to accept me. That's not a problem. That's exactly how I got into this show tomorrow. That's easy for them to accept me. You know what I'm saying? So
that's what I'm saying, bro. It really ain't hard for you to, you know what I'm saying, get back on the bike and keep moving. It really ain't, because if the people who fucking with you and still in they play, it ain't, you got an easy end.
right? I got an easy right. But see, the way I see it is, right, bro, like, I done did that. You know what I mean? Like, I'm looking at the time money with Dre's. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking at that, and I'm looking at they grind. Like, I'm looking at the steps certain people took to where they at. You know what I mean? I'm talking about everybody. Like, everybody that you see in Chicago, the Chance the Rappers, you know what I mean? The people that you didn't see at the open mics. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was a shortcut somewhere. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a shortcut somewhere. You feel me? So I'm trying to find that, you know what I mean? If I'm going to do it and it's going to be a third job and I'm going to take energy, then I need to get revenue from it. You feel me? Like a third job. You know what I'm saying? So I need to figure out that shortcut. You know what I mean? Like, I can't be playing with it no more. You know what I mean?
Give me a couple jewels to... give a couple jewels to this audience, these artists that's coming up with their paperwork, their business, how to go about that, how to get in, you know, to get things licensed and things like that.
Learn your paperwork, please do, because I was in an era where we just wanted to rap. You know what I mean? I was the last of the just wanted to rap era. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. Learn your paperwork, you know what I'm saying? The game is definitely focused on more independent artists than it was when I was coming up, you know what I'm saying? You had to be on the label. You know, we grew up thinking, man, Death Row, Rockefeller, you know, a Bad Boy, you gotta, you know, I need to be on the label, you know what I'm saying? And they grew up with the Young Dolph, Chief Keef, I don't need nobody, I'm still a multimillionaire.
Yeah.
Know? So it's like, learn your paperwork, you know what I'm saying? If I was 5 years younger, or if I was 5 years older, if I was 5 years older, I'd have been with Death Row. You feel me? If I was 5 years younger, I'd have been on. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's like, I just came at the wrong time. You feel me? But if all the young artists know your paperwork, you feel me, and just know your drive is everything. Like, if you ain't got no drive, you ain't got you. You know what I'm saying?
Consistency is the motherfucker.
Consistency. I'm talking about, I done had to do shows, get off 3 a.m, go to the work parking lot, fall asleep, wake up, go into work 2 hours later. Because if I go home, it's a wrap. You know what I mean? Your drive is everything. They got to see you. They got to hear you. Even if they don't like you, they just got to keep seeing you.
What about, when you sitting at these tables, like, or in them offices at the Def Jams and stuff like that, like, because it's not a lot of us in them room or that control the room.
Right.
We might be in the room, the A&Rs and shit might be black, you might have them, but the people who control the shit.
Yeah.
I know you've seen some inside things that's just like, what the fuck?
I mean, I was, like I said, I was down there with Traxxer, and Traxxer was in the offices with no ID. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So I didn't get past the no ID.
Okay.
You know, other than the people that they had engineering, I would go to a studio session and then it'd be one of their engineers or something. But other than that, that's all.
How was your paperwork back then? As far as with, you know, signing to...
My paperwork as far as Traxxer was just a 360, you know what I'm saying? And it was like...
Is it kind of bad though?
Yeah, per project. That's what I'm saying. Like, I didn't, like, back then, you know, I'm talking 2004, 2005, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is way before... You know what I mean? I'm fresh right after the Rockefeller era. That's what I'm saying. Like, it wasn't major independent. This one, Gucci Man, this one, Smack just came out.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's why I'm saying, like, it's the new game. Like, I had love for it. I just wanted to rap. I didn't want to be rich. I didn't care about none of that. I just wanted to rap. You know what I'm saying? And that's why my drive was so much. You know what I'm saying? But people that have a purpose, they drive in like that. You know what I mean?
That is a fact.
And that's what I'm trying to get back to, because then maybe I can do what I was supposed to do. You know what I mean? Because I end up getting money in a different way. I don't get money off rap like that. You feel me? I get money in a whole different direction. You feel me? But so, like, I just know I'm cold with it. You feel me? So it's a craft. You feel me? It's the passion. I don't get nothing. You feel me? I just do it.
Now, but you're definitely going to have to, with, like, these projects that you have, like, are they... You know what I'm saying? Through BMI, ASCAP, license, stuff like that.
Yeah.
See, a lot of people don't even know that. They just make a video throwing this shit on YouTube, Spotify, and letting it be.
Yeah, you got to learn that. Yeah, you got to get the ASCAP, the BMI, you know, the paperwork, you know what I mean, all that. But I don't know. I have a big appetite. I have a spending problem. So you know what I mean? I need a lot of money. So I got a lot of money coming in because I need a lot of money. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't thinking about no that money. You know what I mean?
Yes, sir. Now, balance with the family. Where does I don't know. I have to do it to you.
Go ahead.
With the lady situation. Do you have someone? Do you have the, you know what I mean? Do you have someone special? Or, you know what I mean? I had to do it for ladies, man. Baby, yeah.
Actually, yes. I'm definitely I have a baby mother that I'm definitely trying to take it to another level with. You feel me? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So
does she understand the dream, or where you want to go with it, or do she?
No, not at all.
She don't.
You know what I mean? Not at all. But she you know, we've been back and forth for a long time, you know what I'm saying? And but she's held me down, you know what I mean, when she is around, you know what I mean? And we are on, you know what I'm saying? So it's like you know what I mean? So it's like if it was anything to get real into, you know what I mean? Then yeah, you know what I mean? That would be the one, cuz you know what I mean? That's one.
How does Let me take it back. When you say, you said, when I do something, I'm gonna put everything into it, I'm gonna go straight in, I gotta complete it.
Right.
When you say that, does that mean when you get back into it or whatever you start doing, you can't, you know, you, I know you ain't gonna half ass, and I know it ain't, it's gonna be fun, but it's still gonna take over something. It's gonna take over something within your life to where it's gonna be like, all right, I do gotta be serious about it. It's gonna be fun, but I do gonna be, it's gonna be serious.
Yeah, it's gonna be serious. It's gonna be, because I gotta put money in it.
That's what I'm saying.
So I gotta be serious.
Ain't no time to be wasting no money.
Yeah, no. I just did a song with Louis last year, but I didn't follow up on it with a video, and I'm mad about that. Just like the Mano, I didn't follow up with it, but it took, at the time when I had my baby, it was just, it took too much money to do the video with Mano. You know what I'm saying? So Louis was around the same time, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna follow back up on that, hopefully, and I could put that as a new single. I was trying to put Ty Money on that song with Louis and do the video, you know what I mean? But If I could do it the way I want, I'm gonna try to put the money into this. You know what I'm saying? I'm known for videos, so that would probably be my next project, the video itself.
But you know what? I know you're going for names, but it's still some underground artists out here that's hot.
See, I've heard, I'm gonna be real, you know, I have no other option. I've heard so much boo-boo from younger artists that not many catch my ear, you know what I mean? And I don't even really like I don't even hear them, you know what I mean? But if you point an artist in my way that it didn't, like, I've heard some people on the Icon page, Icon Homegrown, shout out to Icon, shout out to Chuck Moore.
Shout out to the guys.
You feel me? You know what I mean? I heard some people on there that I've never heard before that caught my ear. That was like, these guys hot, but I've never heard them before because, like you said, they probably don't get to look at me like the people that's boo-boo. See, I need to hear them, right? And then I would reach out.
I'm gonna throw a lot of alley oops your way.
Okay.
A lot of, because they hard, bro. Okay. You know what I mean? And now that I'm in it, and you know what I'm saying, I'm getting the look to, I'm at a point to where I'm like, okay, I'm recognized for this.
Right.
This is what people associate. This is the foundation for me.
Right.
Everything else I'm doing with the hostings and stuff like that, and the guest appearances, and the countdown and all that everybody just like, damn, he just moving. But this is where I built everything at.
Right.
So now it's like, I got so many artists coming my way. You know what I mean?
That's dope.
And they fire.
That's dope.
My man, Fly Guy, Jujilla, Southside Point. Who else? Man, it's so many. Uno. He's actually with Shondell. Man.
Really?
Yeah. And I saw you kind of, you know, you...
Yeah. I mess with Shondell. Shondell.
Shout out to the guy. He was here too.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a dude.
You had a few people on your show.
Come on, man. I've been working.
Okay. Yeah.
I've been working, brother.
Because I see you with my boy Mano. I see you with my man that be hosting the strip clubs, Marquise.
Yeah.
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 That's my boy.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I see you. He's a host.
Yes, sir.
You know, I see you with Miss Nina Ross. That's my girl. I used to work with Miss Nina Ross. Shout out to Miss Nina Ross.
Man, that's my childhood friend.
You feel me?
That's my childhood friend.
I'm like, man, I know like four people on this show.
I've been working.
I see you.
Who else would say that? I know that you know. DDP.
DDP.
The one who take the camera.
Oh, yeah. He did a few for me.
I saw a couple pictures. He had the stamp on it.
I might have to reach out to DDP.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. To go ahead and get you glassed up.
Definitely.
Yeah, man. It's just so many people that's doing shit, man. And it's starting to become, you know what I'm saying, full circle.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's starting to become full circle. So once we get big dogs like you come in and, you know what I'm saying, we get the big homies, you know what I'm saying, like, hey, putting us in tune. Now it's like, oh, man, that can maybe open some other doors for us.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because some of the people that you know, I'm trying to get to.
Okay, that's no problem.
You know what I mean?
Easy.
And it's just like, man, but that's how, that's the dynamic that we have to, but a lot of just people just be on some stingy shit.
Bro. Yeah, yeah, they do.
I don't know why.
It's Chicago.
Do you... Once you drop, do you even care what it does here, or do you care what it does to the masses?
I care. I be caring. I mean, you know, like, it's like that's the scary part, because you be like, did I do this for no reason? You know what I mean? Like, I care about the, you know, the home base, the foundation fans. You know what I'm saying? I definitely care about that.
But they don't jump on until you hot.
Exactly.
They don't jump on until you hot. So it's like you care, but then it's just like once you stop caring and then you go somewhere else and you're getting crazy love, i.e. that somebody else, that different fan base that loves you, that's from different places.
Yeah.
And then people make calls like, hey, you don't mess with which girl?
Yeah,
I mess with him.
Yeah.
That's my man.
Yeah.
That shit
comes sometimes. It don't come... I don't know. I just got to get out there more. I always felt like I was sheltered anyway. I felt like I started late. You know what I mean? I felt like I was supposed to be. I feel like the best way to get out there is features.
I don't think it's never too late.
It depends. It depends on the music.
Yeah, it does depend on the music. It
depends on the music.
And how you coming with it. And a lot of shit is like really... A lot of people got short attention spans.
Fact.
So you gotta put that
off top.
You gotta come out strong. You gotta come out strong. But like you said, bro, you seasoned now.
Yeah.
And even some of the rappers that's there, they ain't really getting received. They get the love because of their name and with the work that they put in, but they ain't really received well when the music come back. Like, put it like this. G Count and Bo Deal, they dropped The Purge.
I got it.
I love it, but it wasn't received well.
I definitely, you know, them are my two favorite. Well, Count is definitely one of my favorite Chicago artists. You know what I'm saying? I definitely did something with Count on the last project too.
I've been trying to get Count here, try to get in touch with Count for the longest.
Really?
What?
We could talk about it after the show.
Okay. That'd be epic.
You feel me? Yeah, Count Cold. I'm going to have to call Count back for the new project. You know what I'm saying? Because he definitely blessed my last project. Like, it was nothing. He blessed my last project, you know, and I definitely appreciate that. You know what I mean? But, yeah, he was always one of my favorite growing up. Like, he's one of the ones I used to listen to. Like, I got to paint pictures. Like, he's painting pictures. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? He ain't just talking. Like, he was one of them.
Who, I know you said is. I know you said you ain't really fucking with the scene right now, but who catches that you know of right now? Who catches your ear? And if you were in the industry, who would you feel like your style would be kind of close to?
I don't know. My style changes with the beat. I could be very emotional. I could be very Pac-like, you know what I mean? If the beat causes for that. And then I can get Benny the Butcher-like if the beat causes for that, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know. It depends on the beat, but I don't know. That's a good question.
Hey man, I try to throw, you know what I'm saying, yeah, throw it at them, make people think, you know what I'm saying, get them at that.
Definitely throw it.
You know what? Something I did want to ask you, just life things, man. The things that you were speaking about in your music, man. It wasn't it as we looked at it and we were in it, but it wasn't normal.
No, it wasn't normal.
You see what I'm saying?
The way we, you know, my Chicago life ain't normal.
At all.
Yeah.
But we normalize it.
Yeah, we normalize it. We had to. And I didn't realize that until I started traveling to other people, other states.
And that's what I was finna get to. With it, with your sound being what it, you know what I'm saying, what it was at the time and what you were spending, what you were talking about, and being in the street, now that you think and you are seasoned and you are the man that you are now, like, reflecting on that, what would you tell either your young self or either what would you feel about your young self now? Like, man, I shouldn't have did that. Or do you regret certain things about it?
What you mean, the way I sound?
No, the way you used to think.
Yeah.
About how it was, you normalized the shit that wasn't supposed to be normal.
If I would go back, I would... Yeah, it definitely affected my music, you know what I mean? My music, and that's another problem, like, I feel like my music was too hard. Like, I make hard music, you know what I mean? Like, after you listen to my music, you might go beat somebody up, you know what I mean? It ain't nothing that, and that's bad, though, because it's like, I'm not getting radio play like that, you know what I mean? It's not mm-hmm. commercial, you know what I mean? But then, I just made a song, me and E-Dub, with Triple Darkness, yes. XL did the beat. It's called I'm a G. You know what I mean? That's like the first song is commercial, but it's still gangster. That's why it's I'm a G. Guess but so. Like kids be singing it, so it's like it got to be commercial. You know what I'm saying? Like,
be something to it.
You know what I'm saying?
It got to be catchy for the kids to catch.
It got to be catchy. You know what I'm saying? So it's like maybe this. I would go back and tell myself, this is the lane you need to be pursuing. More catchy gangster music instead of straight gangster music, because the gangster music gonna fade out eventually. And that's what it did.
But the gangsters ain't gangsters no more.
Gangsters ain't gangsters.
It's a lot of pretend gangsters that's trying to be gangster.
It is. It is. But the real gangsters, no. I've performed at shows. I've opened up for Scarface, T.I., you know, and I've got off stage and like 50-year-old OGs that then walked up to me like, I don't know who you are, but I need that CD. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. Like, so, and you know, that's just a dope feeling that it is the OGs versus the certain slow kids. You know what I'm saying? Like the younger generation that ain't about nothing. You know what I mean? I'd rather the OG say, no, this is the CD I need in my car. You know what I mean? Then somebody say, I know I need to go pop a pill overdose to the CD.
Now this is, a catch 22 type of question that I'm finna give you. You're gonna be in an industry to where it's not favorable, but you're gonna have to conform to the industry once you get in it.
Right.
How are you gonna do that when you are so authentic of who you are and still try to show love to the ones that's the boo-boo rappers and stand next to them or maybe get a record with them to, yeah, you know what I'm saying,
get farther.
That's the catch 22. Do you even want to, or is it just like, I might have to do it for the look?
That, you know what's crazy is like, when I first started, you know, with the tracks, the error, that's what I was on. You know what I mean? And I look back at that now and was like, damn, you know, I didn't burn a lot of bridges, but I didn't form a lot of bridges that could have been formed because I was on that. Why am I next to this guy back then? You know what I mean? And it's like these guys, you know, they eventually, you know, they so happy people, you know, they eventually become people. You know what I'm saying? Because they've been happy this whole time. Yes, and then you'd be like, damn, I should have been cool with dude. You feel me? Now he's somebody that I need to holler at. And I treated him, you know what I mean, back in the club 10 years ago. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Do you regret? Because they always say, and I learned this along my journey. You never know who somebody gonna be.
Yeah, you never know, and I regret that. You know what I mean? Because I was definitely. I don't know. I just, you know where we from. We don't, you don't really talk to people. You know what I mean? I don't know you. Why am I talking to you in the club? You know what I'm saying? So it was like, you know what I mean? But, you know, like you said, it's a part of the rap game, networking, you know what I mean? Yes. And I didn't know that then. So it's like, you definitely got to be friendly, network with everybody. It don't matter what they bring to the table. You know what I mean? He could be beneficial, you know what I'm saying? Or you might need that connection. You know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna say one thing that we gonna get into the game, bro. You still, and hitter, back me up if I'm on the right track. You still got the OG style type of persona edge to you.
Okay.
It's like I see the rappers that come in here and stuff like that. You still got that. OG, I don't do too much talking. Everything I say, boom, that's what it is. Next thing.
Right.
You still got that persona, bro.
Right.
I'm just letting you know. It's like, I know you cool. Every time when we came in, it's, what's up, bro? What's up, bro? Woo, woo. But when you talking.
Right.
It's a.
Right. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Hitter, what you think?
No, that's bad. What's he said is that.
That's what it is.
It's all right.
Ain't nothing else to say about it.
Yeah, you know, that's my other half right here. You know, he's the talker. You know what I'm saying? He's the talker. I'm telling you, like we be on stage, and you know, it'd be times where you can't just rap straight 20 minutes.
You gotta fill in.
He dub.
Go ahead.
I'm not the talker, like, you know. That's why I wasn't talking to them guys 10 years ago, you know what I'm saying? Like, E-Dub was talking to them, you know what I'm saying? But now, like, E-Dub's drive is gone, too. It's leaving, too. You know what I mean? He's been doing it longer than me. So it's like he's really drying out. So I'm trying to, now that I got it back, I'm trying to bring him back up, you know what I'm saying? Because he motivates me, you know what I'm saying? He motivated me in the beginning. He was the guy signed to Trackster that Trackster was putting everything into. And he was the guy saying, no, you need to listen to the dude in the corner. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Dude in the corner writing some shit over there. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And then that's how I got it, my deal. You know what I'm saying?
Do you, what was I about to say? Do you want, what is success to you, bro? What is going to be the success if that's even a
thing in life or in rap?
Both.
Success in life is just wealthiness, you know what I mean? Health, prosperous, you know what I mean? Being able to do what you want to do when you want to do it, you know what I mean? Eating, you know what I mean? Raising your child, and you know what I mean? Like, just peaceful, you know what I mean? Like, just not, no forms of poverty, you know what I mean? That's success to me, you know what I mean? Like, we eating, we straight, you know what I mean? We always going to be straight, you know what I'm saying? But in rap, I never wanted to be Michael Jordan, you know what I mean? I just wanted to be on the team, you know what I mean? I never cared if I was coming off the bench. I just wanted to be on the team, you know what I mean? So it's like, I was cool with that, you know what I mean? It was me, E-Dub, direct from Triple Darkness, Mickey Halsted, Tia London, and Sable on the label, you know what I mean? And I didn't have to be the best rapper. I wasn't the worst, but I didn't have to be the best, you know what I mean? My album didn't have to come out this year, you feel me? I just wanted to be on the team, you know what I mean? Yeah. So it's like, that's success to me, you know what I mean? Like, you never, it's going to be 1,000 rappers out here every year, you know what I mean? And it's like, you can, you know what I mean? We can battle or whatever, but it's always going to be somebody nice, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, as long as you know I'm nice.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't have to be better than you, but as long as you know that dude nice too, you know what I mean? Like, that's all I care about.
What stage do you, I feel like it's 3 stages in life. What stage would you say you at? The beginning stage to where you, right now, do you feel like you trying to get things back started and like, all right, I'm going to go through the motions. Let me go ahead and get prepped. Or do you think you're in the middle, the middle to where it's like, I got something, I obtained something. So I'm just trying to juggle and find my way and actually uphold it and excel more. Or do you feel like you coasting to where you could just be cool? I'm at almost my wit's end, but I'm still gonna do this, and whatever come out of it, I'm gonna just coast after that.
You mean life? I mean,
because with rap, I really feel like it's some unfinished business within you that's just like, I gotta get this shit off.
It is. I mean, I don't have to get it off, but I know, like, I just be listening to stuff like, I'll kill that. You know what I mean? Like, so you know what I mean? It's definitely unfinished business. But like you said, at a time where I had such a childhood, you know what I mean? I had 20, 30 friends not here no more, dead, you know what I mean? For whatever reason, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just happy to be here. You know what I mean? I'm just happy to be here with my own bread, how I want it, you know what I mean? Doing what I want when I want, with my son, you know what I mean? And my girl or whatever, you know what I mean? Like, I'm cool with that. Like, that's, I won. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like, you know what I mean? Like, because at the end of the day, it's like I said, this rap game getting younger, you know what I mean? Ain't nobody finna sign no 40, 50-year-old. I mean, you know what I mean? They going younger because they going dumber. You know what I mean? They trying to save their money, so they going dumber. All the smarter is going independent. You feel me? So it's like, I ain't getting younger, so that means that's out for me. You feel me? So I gotta play the cards I'm dealt. You know what I mean? The cards I'm dealt right now is my son, you feel me? Hopefully getting married soon, you know what I'm saying? And like, you know, just growing all the way up, you know what I mean? Because like I said, ain't nobody at the court no more. Ain't nobody shooting at the basketball court no more.
That's real. Gee, shit, man. I'm playing the cards that I'm dealt. That's it.
Can't do nothing else.
You can't do, but people try to make shit more than what it is, or they feel like gotta do extra or go above and beyond. It's just like, no, just play what you got.
I've been doing that so long though. Like I created everything I'm at. You know what I mean? So it's like I'm tired.
Yeah.
I'm tired. Like I'm talking about train rides. I mean, like I didn't have a hell of a time. I'm talking about when I used to live downtown, you know what I mean? I used to hop on the train to 47, you know what I mean? Midnight, you know what I mean? Walk to Michigan, you feel me? Like midnight, you know what I mean? Be in the studio with these guys 3 a.m, walk back to 47 state, you feel me? Cop on the train, go back downtown 2-3 a.m, you feel me? Like just to say, no, I'm with this shit with y'all, you feel me? Fuck with me, you feel me? No, I really own this shit, to the point where they was like, okay, we picking you up, you feel me? Yeah. You see us, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh no, here's a deal, you see us, you know what I mean? Like, I used to be on that shit, you feel me? Like, I used to be on this rap shit hard, so it's like, I'm tired. You feel me? I'm tired. I got money. I'm straight. I'm eating. You feel me? I got my family. You feel me? My son, my girl. You feel me? I'm eating. I can relax. I put my feet up. You know what I mean? Write a rap. Put it out. You like it, you don't. I'm eating regardless.
I dig that.
You feel
me?
And like you said, at the end of the day, I got the connection, so let me call Twista or let me call King Louie. Get him on a video. You know what I'm saying? Put the money into this. Do a quick video just to let y'all know I'm still one of the coldest niggas out here.
Yeah.
And y'all done slept on me.
Yeah, yeah.
Then I'm going back to kick it with my son.
Talk that talk.
You know what I mean?
Talk that talk. All right, look. You don't know what that mean. Hit it. We ready for it? Yeah. All right. This means I got a game, man. It's called the 10-name game. So basically what's going to happen is I fire off 10 things or 10 names. They're all going to be random as shit. And you just got to give me your answer in a one-word answer.
You mean like the first thing come to my mind?
First thing to pop to your mind, boom. So if I say music, first thing to come to your mind would be what?
Tupac.
Boom. That's it. Okay. That's how the game go. And they all random. They all random as shit.
Okay.
Ready for it?
Yes, sir.
Here you go. All right. Money.
That's the first thing that come to my mind.
Love.
My son.
God. One word. One word. It gotta be one. If you could describe God in one word to you, what he means to you, what would that be?
He everything.
Everything. Take that. Your mother.
Love.
Chicago.
My heart.
Son.
My heart. Leave my heart. Let me switch up to Chicago. What if you want me to change that one up?
Change that with a give Chicago something else.
Boom.
Boom. I'll take that. I'll take that. E-Dub.
Brother.
Twist.
Go.
Your life. If you could describe your life in one word from then to right now in this present time, how could you describe that in one word?
Hectic.
Damn. I've never heard that before. That's new, ain't it? I never heard that before,
bro. I've been through some shit, bro. You have no idea. Like, you know, we touching on shit, but yeah, I mean, I say, I write a book. You feel me? Like, I done been through some shit that nobody been through. You know what I mean? Like, often.
Shit.
You feel me? Often.
Your music. What does your music mean to you in one word?
Therapy.
Yeah. Yeah. Have it up. Have it up. Have it up. Yeah. I take that. I take that. So, what we do, we give you a grade. We got to give you a grade after this. So, brother hitter. With this brother, with Dutch, we got to be biased. We got to be a little biased. We got to be a little biased because he is low-key OG. So, you know, what would you give him?
I give him a solid A.
A solid A. And why is that?
He thought about the answers. He gave good answers. Yeah, I mean, he was pretty, I don't even say fast, but he didn't, you know, take like 30 years to answer.
Gotcha. Yeah, I give him an A. No, I give you an A+ because that shocked me when you said your life. Man. Hectic. Most people would say, man, like blessed, or you might put hectic.
I mean, it's blessed. It's blessed because of the route I've taken. You know what I mean? And where I'm at now, I'm blessed now. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, I guess you're blessed just for waking up in the morning. You know what I mean? If you want to look at it like that. But at the same time, I've been through some shit. You know what I mean? Like, I done had like 5 lives. You know what I mean? And when I say 5 lives, I'm talking about like 5 different careers/friends. This is a different set of friends, and I don't even talk to them no more. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? This set of friends, I don't talk to them no more. You know what I mm-hmm. mean? This is, a, you know what I mean? 5. And I live over here now. You know what I mean? Like, it's my life over here for this.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean? So, it's been hectic, you feel me? Like, now at this point, I could say it's somewhat peaceful, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, I've always wrote raps though through each life. You
yeah.
know I mean, that's the twist, you know what I mean? I just always wrote raps, but it's like my rap life is a whole different life, you know what I mean? Like I said, my Thornridge people don't come to shows, you know what I mean? Like, that's a whole different life, you know what I mean? When if I go to this 20-year reunion, they don't know nothing about Inglewood, Kenny, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? They don't know nothing about, you know yes, what sir. I mean? Rap Dutch, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, man, they, and then I twist it up and go kick it with Crucial Conflict, and then they don't, you know what I mean? Like, it's just different lives, you know what I'm saying?
Any, what's the name for the next project? What you think you're gonna name it?
Legendary. I wanted the Legendary. I wanted it to be seasoned, but then I didn't want people to think I was talking about some seasoning.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go with the Legendary, you know what I'm saying? Because it's an advanced flow, you know what I'm saying? It's definitely like growth. And I know people, I dropped my first video in like 2005. It was called Suicide Note, you know what I'm saying? It was the cheapest video in the world. Like, I mean, like it was worse than Master P Bout It. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was the worst video ever. But it was real, you know what I mean? And people yeah. felt it, you know what I'm saying? So like, I do my own videos, you know yeah. what I'm saying? So the video I dropped, the one that Mano saw, you know what I mean, in 2000, I'm a G featuring Triple Darkness.
Yes, sir.
Like, you could just see the growth. I'd have had at least 12 videos in between this span, 12, 13 videos. I'm talking about, you could just see from Bout It to better to aggression. Better to better to 4K to movie. It's, you know what I mean? Dutch Scorsese. You feel me? I'm doing movies. You feel me? That's the name of that. Now when you cut on my video, that's what it say. Dutch Scorsese. This is a Dutch Scorsese situation. You feel me? Like I'm doing movies now. You feel me? So it's like shout out to Miguel, my cameraman. You feel me?
Shout out.
Like we definitely do movies. You know what I'm saying? So it's just good to see. You know, for me to see back, like, damn, that was some bullshit I was doing. Like, like, and now, like, I'm glad like you own it. You know what I'm saying? So,
yes,
it's just dope.
Brother, I appreciate you, man. It was more of a getting to know you.
Yes, sir.
And getting some of the story and, kind of filling in the pockets.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what kind of the show is revolved around. But also, man, just giving some of my listeners, my younger people that watch me and be like, damn, well, let me go do my research on him too.
Right, right.
And so they can understand where some of this shit and who you tapped in with and plugged with and, yeah. You know what I'm saying, bring you more people your way, bro.
Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
Tell everybody how they can get in contact with you and just the shit you got coming up.
You can check me out. Like I said, I got this show tomorrow, April 29th at the Forge, you know what I mean? Headlining Twister, Psychodrama, Triple Dark, The Snipers, you know what I mean? Me and E-Dub, guest appearances, you know what I'm saying? Sweet Juices is going down. Old doors open at 7, be there, you know what I mean? My Instagram is The Dutchman, THADUTCHMEN, you feel me? My Facebook is Dutch Backwoods. And my Instagram channel, my YouTube channel is The Dutchman, you know what I mean? Like, you should definitely check me out. We got some bangers on there, you know what I mean? Visuals are going to be upcoming, you know what I'm saying? I got, you know, videos with Twister. I got videos with Rico Reckless, you know what I'm saying? Bodeo, Speed Not Mobsters, you know what I'm saying? Everybody, you know what I mean? I'm in tune with a little bit of everybody, you know what I'm saying? So definitely get in tune with me for this last go round if we got it, you know what I mean? And we're gonna take you on a trip, you feel me?
And it's on. Y'all already know where to find me, man. Fish _ YUNG Gotti on Instagram, G World Media, Avion Studios, hitter. Appreciate you, bro.
What's up?
Dutch.
Love.
My brother. I appreciate you, man.
Appreciate you too.
It's another one, man. Gotti's World. We out of here. Yeah.
Yes.
Gotti, hard body, Gotti's World, we some mob bosses. Tune in, don't just come across. We do it all, y'all just for the talk. Might lose your mind when you hear these topics, no cap, think about it. Who you know going this hard, all real, all wait, think about it. Best interview, so is this. We don't do oldest, that entrepreneurship. Coming late, join the viewership. Education, relationships, businesses, beauty clips. This the Midwest takeover, going over time to invent, I'm focused. Bringing guests in from all over, whole lot of game, we don't need a closer. Gotti, hard body, Gotti's World, we some mob bosses. Turn them L's to lessons, we don't do the losses. Dedication daily, ain't no other options. Booking up these lots on every show, we plotting. Pull up a chair, make sure you watching. Subscribe, get them notifications popping. Pull up all the champagne, we gon' get it poppin'.
I gotta feed the streets, my pistol gon' bleed the streets. Ski mask on my face, sometimes you gotta cheat to stay ahead in this bitch. Drank surf like it's liquor. Street life, I have you catching up to God quicker. Sticker, AK-40 to your lip. Let the chopper bang on you like a blood or a cripper. Flipper, so much bread, I'm a gymnast. Made so much money off of dummies.
Yeah,
gang.
I miss the body catcher, slaughter gang soul snatcher. Ain't no regular F-150, this a fucking Raptor. No capper, street nigga, not a rapper.